I keep telling you not to do it. They're a real pain, you know?
Cripes, you never shut up, do you? Just shut up, you little shit. Shut up before I cut you down right now.
I thought you called me because you needed me. You're the one who's getting impatient. Well, I'm going for a walk.
Son of a bitch! I really am gonna kill him sooner or later! Hey, switch with me!
Looks like you're awake.
What have you done with the others? Let them go, at once!
So those are your first words after regaining consciousness. I don't think you understand your situation.
I understand that I've been captured by some boorish people at the very least. Who are you? Is this all your doing?
That was a pointless question. Even if it is, what are you going to do about it? Jump down off that cross and kill me?
Shuji Kutsuki, is this revenge for him?
Revenge? A pointless word. What do you think of the previous performance? It must have seemed like something from Ikutsuki's own mind.
Performance?
Don't worry. He's dead. Not just dead, but killed. You must understand. You're a Kirijo.
Are you trying to say that we killed him? But he was...
Ikutsuki doesn't matter. You're nothing but bait after all.
What?
I've shown them how you've been captured. How touching. Your comrades are gathering one after another.
What are you after? What do you intend to do to my comrades?
Even your calm, collected facade cracks when your little friends are involved. Don't worry. You'll all die together eventually. Not just you, but all life itself. I will destroy this world. Everything will die. And this place will be reborn into a new world. His world. Where only one life remains.
His world? Preposterous. I don't know how you intend to bring this about, but I won't let you create a world like that.
I don't need your understanding. All I will do is grant a boy his wish.
Boy?
That's right. Doesn't it ring a bell, Kirijo? Your desires created that boy and gave birth to me.
What?
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Minazuki. Sho Minazuki. I am the embodiment of your sins. Just take your time and wait.
Wait!
There's nobody around. I hope everyone's okay.
I found you.
Yukon? Oh, thank goodness you're here!
Yeah, I was waiting for you. I knew you'd be coming here.
Huh? You ain't Yukon. You're a shadow.
Not bad, anti-shadow suppression weapon. Then again, I never intended to deceive you by taking this form.
Showing up looking like Yukon. What's your game, buddy?
I came to warn you. Where you are is not where you should be.
What are you saying?
Don't get so worked up. Don't you know it? Deep down, you know that you're nothing but trouble to them. If you'd never shown up, this town would have been peaceful. They don't think of you as a friend. You're just a nuisance that brought them to Scorn.
Well, that's... But they all accepted me for who I am!
No matter what excuse you give, you're still just a weapon. A tool can never befriend a human, and you will never be accepted by them either.
That ain't true! That can't be!
What about you, Labrys? What'll you do?
I hope Mitsuru-san and the others are okay. Could you please go right to that tower? We'll head over there too as soon as we can. I am a weapon. My body is mechanical, and my heart was given to me. No matter what I wish I was, I can never be human.
Oh?
But Yukon-sama, Mitsuru-san and Yukari-san, and even Ken-kun all think of me as someone precious. I'm the fifth generation anti-shadow suppression weapon. I'm Labrys, a member of the Shadow Operatives.
I see. Since you were just awakened to your persona, I thought you could be shaken up again. But circumstances have changed. I'll have to change by force! Now bring on the ring!
You really want to do this, huh? Sorry, but I ain't about to hold back.
Don't underestimate me. I may be artificial, but I'm a complete copy, based on everything there is to know about the real person. I'll prove it to you. Persona!
No way! They can't be!
Now, show the true power of an anti-shadow weapon!
Yeah! good fight. That was sufficient. My objective has been accomplished.
It really was a shadow. Labra-san! Ken-kun! Koromaru-san! I'm so glad you're safe! Is something wrong? Okay. If anything comes up, please feel free to talk to me about it. That is, if you're okay with sharing it with me. See, that must have been tough.
Yeah, I got to wondering what I would do if the real Yukun thought the same way. And that got me all scared.
It's difficult to truly believe in other people.
Ken-kun?
It would be easy for me to say that he'd never think that way about you. But people are weak. They can't help but believe in things that make life easier for them. That's only deceiving yourself, though. You need to have resolve if you want to learn the truth. Even if that means getting hurt yourself. Miss Olf, if you're worried about the truth, then I believe you should go to him directly and find out how he feels. Otherwise, you'll never be true friends.
Ken-kun.
Oh, I'm sorry for being so impolite. It's easy to tell others to learn unpleasant truths, but it's more like I'm trying to convince myself.
I see. A relationship between two people cannot be formed until they speak their minds to one another. Doing so requires this resolve.
Who's there? Who are you?
Ah, how truly rude of me. My name is Theodore. I didn't intend to eavesdrop on you. But, as I wandered in search of cola, I found myself here.
That blue costume. Are you connected to Elizabeth?
My! So you know of my sister?
Labra-san, is this person an enemy?
Probably not. Elizabeth helped me realize a ton of stuff, but, well, she came on a little strong sometimes.
Oh? Was she rude to you? She once forced me to eat a large quantity of cinnamon, and I thought my mouth was going to be desiccated forever.
Cinnamon?
Please, don't worry about it. It is merely a bittersweet page from our youths.
I see.
Oh, right. My name's Labrys. This is Ken-kun and Koromaru-san. They're my... well...
It's nice to meet you, Theodore. We're Labrys-san's comrades.
Comrades.
Thank you for the polite introductions. It is a pleasure to meet you. By the way, on a different subject, has anyone seen my sister, Elizabeth, anywhere?
Elizabeth? Nah, the last time I saw her was in a dream. I haven't seen her around here.
Is that so? There's something I was meaning to ask her if I managed to find her. I saw traces of cinnamon along the road here, so I thought that she might have come this way. Ah, please forgive me. It seems I've detained you for too long. Please, do not be alarmed. I have no intention of getting in your way.
Oh, that's right. We need to hurry. Labrasan, shall we get going?
Huh? But don't we have to wait for Yukari-san?
Do you remember what that General Teddy said when he showed up on the monitor?
Oh, if we don't fight and win the P1 climax within an hour, the world will end.
Yes, that's why I think it's important we rescue Mitsuru-san and the others as quickly as possible. Yukari-san will be fine. Junpei-san's strong too, after all.
Alright, let's go. See ya, Theodore.
Please, take care. Still, where am I to obtain this cola?
Koromaru-san? It would seem there's someone inside this classroom. Sonata-san, we'll get you down at once!
Who? Ken? Thanks for saving me, Ken, Labrus, and Koromaru too?
Sorry to barge in on you. I couldn't wait to hear your story, so I came here.
I'm glad you're so impatient. Sorry about this.
I'm glad you're safe now. Where are the others?
Am I late again? Sorry guys, my bad. Oh hey, Ken and Koromaru! And, are you Labrus?
Junpei-san, it's been a long time! I'm glad you made it here. Did you run into Yukari-san along the way?
Glad? You're glad about stealing the limelight from me? I wasn't gonna try to hide it anyway.
I've never faced Junpei-san before.
Hey, Ken-kun, are you okay with fighting somebody who looks just like one of your buddies? I mean, aren't you afraid? Like, what if that's the real one?
That's a silly question, Labrus-san. Even if it did turn out to be the real Junpei-san, if I'm truly being challenged, then I can never back down.
Truly challenged?
Yes. When it comes down to it, I will stand up and fight for anything I truly believe in. Even if I must do so against my own companions.
Looks like you're finally learning to talk like that, Ken.
Akihiko-san!
Labrus, let me tell you something. Even if the enemy you face is someone you once counted as a friend, in a battle for your beliefs, the bonds formed between true comrades will never break.
Are you trying to bore me to submission? Let's get this over with already. Bring on the ring!
Selfish rules as always. Now, normally I'd take him on, but let me take a quick break from the fighting for now.
Yes, please rest, Sonata-san. We can handle this.
I can do it too!
We'll be right back. doing?
Go, Koromaru! Go, strike! Go! Koromaru!
How?
Get out of here, sir!
You bastard!
How?
Do it!
You bastard! Strike! Go, Koromaru! Koromaru! Go, Koromaru!
How?
Don't give him time to count. Bastard!
Koromaru, go!
Finish you off!
This is gonna be a one-sided...
Koromaru!
All that's left...
Concentrate! With this attack, you're history! Now's not the time for me to give up! There is a reason we need to get stronger. Are you all right, Tsunade-san?
I wish I could say I was, but I'm pretty exhausted. I won't be able to call on my persona for a while. I guess that cross drains the spiritual energy from whoever's stuck on it.
Weird. The same thing happened to the fake Yukun too.
It's flowing up. Does that mean it's being collected somehow? What in the world is that?
There's something else that I've noticed. Everyone in Inaba aside from us Persona users has vanished. Doesn't that remind you of the Dark Hour and Tartarus?
That's ominous. If I remember right from last time we were here, the enemy was trying to turn Personas into shadows and collect their power. And we know all too well what happens when shadows gather in Tartarus.
Tsunade-san, immediately after we reached Inaba, we were attacked by someone who looked very similar to Ikutsuki.
Ikutsuki? That's impossible. We saw him.
Yes, though I don't know if it was really him. But one of the Persona users from Inaba, Naoto-san, knew about Ikutsuki.
The detective, huh? So they're running around out there too.
Indeed. I wanted to find an explanation to this situation as soon as possible, so we shared what we knew with each other.
This is their town. No matter how much we might try to stop them, they have the right to protect this place. Mitsuru knows that at least, though it seems like she was trying to bear the entire burden herself again. And they're all incredibly skilled, too. If we can meet up with them, we'll be able to solve this case that much quicker. You made the right call, Ken.
Thank you.
Ikutsuki, huh? If he's really behind this, then we're at even more of a disadvantage. Sorry, Ken, but let me make sure I've got it all straight. So we fell right into the enemy's trap and got ourselves captured. How careless of us.
By the way, Tsunade-san, how have Mitsuru-san and the others been? I haven't seen them in a while.
I hadn't seen her in a long time till I got back either. Don't worry, she hasn't changed at all. If anything, she seemed even more dreadful.
I see. I don't know if I should feel relieved or worried.
What, does Mitsuru-san scare you two? She's always really nice to me.
You just don't know how frightening she can be. Try getting hit with that kick of hers. You won't eat normally for a week.
She's very intense. And that's coming from me. Now that I think about it, I can't believe she was just a high school student when we met.
Huh. If that's the case, then I'll try asking her to start being nicer to you two.
You can't!
You don't have to get so flustered, you know?